Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to play Forza Horizon 5 using just a computer mouse. This is perfect if you can't use a keyboard or controller. So the first thing you guys need to do is head over to this website called AltController.net. This is an open source software that makes games more accessible. Once you're on the website, you need to click the green download button. Next, you need to install the program. If this message comes up, just click more info and then click run anyway. Click next, 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 next. There, the program's installed. Now we need to download the profile for Forza Horizon 5. This saves you a lot of time as the whole profile is already created. So in the top right, click resources and then click profiles. Then scroll down a bit and where it says Forza Horizon 4, download the profile. I know it says it's for Forza Horizon 4, but it also works for Forza Horizon 3 and 5. Once you have the profile, extract it onto your desktop. Next, you need to run AltController. Once you open it, you should get a window like this. There's a few settings we need to change. Go to View and click Show Region Names and Show Mode Page Overlay. Next, you need to go to Tools, Options, and check off Show Region Names and Show Mode Page Overlay. Once you do that, click OK. Next, you need to load the Forza Horizon 5 profile. So go to File, Open, go to the folder with the profiles, and you should see a list of the profiles. As you can see, there's different profiles. So each one is a different mouse sensitivity. So I usually use the QWERTY ones, and I usually choose sensitivity 4 because it works best for me. So once you click it, click open, and you should see these buttons at the bottom of your screen. Each one of these buttons does an action. So if I hover over tab, it clicks tab in the game. If I hover over drive, it activates drive mode. If I hover over undo, it rewinds in game. If I hover over map, it opens the map. And if I hover over enter, it presses enter in game. So let's start the game up and I'll show you guys some gameplay. So once you're in game, hover over drive and it activates drive mode. If I move my mouse forward, I go forward. And if I move it left and right, I turn. You can also brake by clicking. See, it's pretty easy. See, I'm moving the mouse left and right for which way I want to turn. Let's say we crash. So you hover over undo, and it rewinds. Hover over undo again. One more time. One more time. Then hover over enter to resume. So if you hover over escape, it opens the menu. And you can do everything else using your mouse. Escape again to close it. If you hover over map, it opens the map. And if you hover over escape, it closes the map. So let's try doing a race now. For racing, I recommend you guys to turn on these settings. I recommend to do assisted steering a tiny bit because it helps with the steering. Because it's kind of hard to do some of the steering with a mouse only. So this really helps. I also recommend that you turn on assisted braking and stability control and traction control. For a driving line, you could just use braking only if you want because it's good enough to me. So these are my settings that I usually use. So at the start of the race, you need to hover over drive. Let's beat these guys. So I'm just hovering over to the top of my screen to accelerate. And I'm moving the mouse left and right depending on which direction I want to go. So hover over undo because we missed a checkpoint. One more time. Then hover over enter to resume. And then I lost some distance. And you catch up. Oh, sorry. See, it's pretty easy to play like this, actually. If this video helped, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, please comment and I will try my best to help you.